Evolution. Yes, Cheryl from Kentucky, it is real. Anyway, let's get into the evolution of animals summarized. Chaotically. Everything started out as a single-celled organism, but now let's skip to the part where everything became multicellular. During the Cambrian explosion. Okay, so here you got your main factions. Let's go through them. You got your arthropods on one end of things. Your mollusks. You got fish. Okay, let's review the mollusks. We got our cephalopods. We got gastropods. And bivalves. Which don't really move. They just kind of hide in a shell, that's it. Arthropods, we got a few to go over. There's Opabinia, world's first sniper. This thing had a trunk built for precision. A great adaptation. But unfortunately, this thing took a weird approach to things. It thought it would be a good idea to shrink down to a smaller size on the microscopic level and become immortal. For no reason. And that's how water bears are a thing. So now they just roll up into a ball and become invincible. Then we got the trilobite. It's got heavy defenses. But the real big shot of this era was the Anomalocaris. It had the same grabbing technique as the Opabinia, but it had the strength to flip things over. Too bad for the trilobite. Defenses countered. And then we got fish. Just fish. They're not really diversified yet in any way, but they'll get their chance. First thing they did that changed everything. They decided to grow legs and go on to land. And with that, I give you amphibians. Well, some arthropods and gastropods followed behind. So now we got amphibians and arthropods on land. Some arthropods even grew wings. We'll get back to them in a moment. So now, the amphibians are living close to the bogs. They lay eggs in the water. They live up on land. That's the idea. But some of them were like, nah, I'm not doing this. I'm gonna leave. I'm gonna go even farther onto land. Check in with them later. And now we come to the Devonian period. What a time to be a fish. Fish have diversified their strategies, finally. Now we see signs of the first shark. But there was one fish who ruled it all. The Dunkleosteus. It was one of the biggest fish of the time. It quickly dominated the oceans. Which was bad news for everyone else. Anyway, remember when I was talking about those amphibians that, you know, walked onto land? Well, now introducing Amphibians Dry Edition, also known as reptiles. Their progress going further onto land was only assisted by a new invention, the eggshell. They formed a shell around the egg and filled it with water. That's it. But now they could put their eggs on land. Or go in places. And I also should mention plants were starting to grow on land as well. And there were a lot of them. And that means more oxygen. And for some reason that also means the bugs became bigger than everything else. Introducing the griffin fly and Arthropleura. Meanwhile, life in the ocean wasn't really affected by any of this. Also, this thing was here too. I don't know what it is. No one knows what it is, but it was there. Then there was a mass extinction, but never was a bigger one. We don't know what caused it, but a bunch of things died out. And in terms of reptiles, there were only three survivors. Yes. Like, actually three. Like, only three. That's it. 3. Anyway, here they are. Anyway, this one sticks with the general reptile strategy. This thing is about to become the mammals. But they're both about to get dominated by this thing. Yes? I think you know where this is going. Get ready for the dinosaurs. And so begins the Triassic era. I know they don't look like much now, but trust me, it gets worse. And it was enough to draw the attention of a few lizards who decided to retreat into the ocean where they would be safe. And that's how we have ichthyosaurs. Also, some cephalopod just decided to stop having a shell because it wanted to go fast. Anyway, time for the Jurassic period. Let's check in on the whole dinosaur situation. So now they're starting to diversify into different groups, such as the neotheropods. They quickly became the apex predators of this time. And one of them needs no introduction, and is why I cut this segment so short. Then we got another classification that I forgot how to pronounce as I was recording this. Anyway, they had solid defenses, with lots of horns and plates and whatnot. And then finally, the sauropods, they quickly became bigger than everything else. Things are not looking good for the mammals. Anyway, another group also descended from these things was the pterosaurs, who figured out how to fly. We'll get back to them later. Also, turtles. Now it's on to the Cretaceous. And from those pterosaurs came the birds. We'll get back to them in a moment. But here's one other development that we must go over. The situation getting worse, some lizards decided to run away into the ocean again. And because of the way gravity works underwater, they were able to grow a lot. And with that, I give you the Mosasaurus. It quickly dominated the ocean. And then some cephalopods were like, activating stealth mode. And descended into the ocean floor. We'll see what happened to them in a moment. Actually, a long time, like a few million years. Anyway, but not only did this thing dominate the ocean, it managed to dominate against the biggest threat of the time. That's right. The dinosaurs. This thing, like, a T-Rex walks up to the shore. This thing would just drag it into the ocean. But other than those few times where it got to drag a few of them into the ocean, the dinosaurs still much dominated this time period. That was until they were all wiped out. Don't know why, but they were. Anyway, those underwater lizards would be to follow. But I'm just saying, when you think of apex predators of the Cretaceous, consider the Mosasaurus. Well, after that, things were looking better for the lizards. But things were looking even better for the mammals. And of course, they began to diversify their strategies. And with that, we have monotremes, marsupials, and placentals. Also, some lizards stopped having legs and got really long, you know, for stealth. Some birds have evolved closer to the water. So would numerous lizards, which would come to be known as crocodilians. Time for the Eocene era. Remember these three? Well, one of them's about to get a whole lot more diverse. That's right, the placentals. A lot to go over here. First up, we got primates, ungulates, bats, and pachyderms. There was one ungulate in particular that was like, nah, this is too much competition, I'm leaving. If you learned anything from before, I think you know what it did. It went into the water and got really long. And with that, I give you the Basilosaurus, which is kind of not a good name for it since it's, you know, not a lizard. Also, this thing was here too. Anyway, Oligocene time. Ungulates would further diverge from here, creating prehistoric ancestors of dogs and cats. Also, equids. In particular, something that looked quite similar to a modern-day horse, except it was 2 feet tall. Also, camel. Pachyderms would also diverge here as well, with a few ancestors of the rhinoceros appearing during this time. And of course, the new apex predator on land, the Entelodon, also known as the Hell Pig. Also, I should mention, the Nearhorn Beast, the largest mammal to ever walk on land. But you know who would trump its size in the mammal category? Whales, evolved from the Basilosaurus, forming two distinct groups. Toothed whales, which were smaller and typically more aggressive. And of course, baleen whales, which had decided to trade out their teeth for bristles because they're that desperate. But it did seem to work, as they began just inhaling a bunch of krill. Anyway, time for the Miocene period. We have some new contenders now. Red pandas, bovids, apes, bears, raccoons, and giant sloths. Anyway, things in the ocean became an all-out arms race to see who could become the apex predator of the ocean, mainly between toothed whales and the megalodon, a new shark that would arise during this time.
I think it's safe down here.
That's right. Those mollusks from earlier, they're back. You got the octopus. It can squeeze through tight places. And the cuttlefish, which can grab from a distance. And they both have amazing camouflage, and some of the most advanced camouflage in the entire animal kingdom. They would soon dominate the reefs. Anyway, remember the hell pig? Well, it's still very much around. But some members of this species decided to try different strategies. Some decided to become scavengers and look for stuff under the dirt. Some wanted to live in ponds. And with that, I give you the Earth Pig and the Limbo Pig. Some apes figured out how to stand upright. We'll get back to them in a moment. Some turtles decided to become dry again. We see the first ancestors of elephants with mastodons and mammoths. New bovids, such as sheep and cows. They're all in for a lot. You guessed it. It's human time. They began creating fire, making tools, and talking, making their own shelters. Their territory expanded great distances all across the globe. I don't think they can reach over here.
Ice Age.
And that's how we got here. Tune in next time where I explain the entire FNAF lore. And as always, I'm MSR Gaming and I don't do fancy outros.